Hey, what's up? John Salmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I got this question from Simeon, and Simeon says, hello, John, I've been watching your YouTube videos for quite some time now. First off, thank you for the invaluable input and for sharing these lessons with us. It's difficult to find quality advice in this immense ocean of online knowledge. I left my job at HP a couple of months ago to pursue a career as a front-end developer in a smaller company with the idea that I could develop my programming skills faster. Now I start to regret my decision, mainly because the way my new company conducts code reviews. The code reviews are done post-commit and are never one-to-one. The reviewer, always the same person, leaves passive-aggressive comments. Example, this is not good. Never do that again. What the hell? Oh my. That do not contribute to the way I write code or my skills as a developer. I've researched every never do that again, trying to understand the reasoning behind the comments. And while some of them have valid basis, most are just a matter of perspective and do not alter performance or code readability. When I ask what's wrong with my implementation, all I get is you tell me or think about it. My question is to you is, how do I deal with such passive aggressive code review comments and whether I should consider looking for another job? Thank you for your help. So you've got a few options here, Simeon. So, I mean, well, first of all, let's talk about boundaries here. So you should have clear boundaries, right? Someone should not violate your boundaries. You need to make that clear. You do not have to accept things that you do not want to accept. No one has the right to come and invade your space and criticize you unless you are going to allow that. Now, I don't want to say that you shouldn't accept criticism. I mean, I did a video on how you should basically never give criticism, but you should accept criticism, right? You want to be that kind of a person. So there is that. But at the same time, you shouldn't tolerate abuse, right? And to me, I don't know exactly, but this is starting to sound a little bit like abuse in this case. So I don't know if I would stick around and tolerate this. I mean, you've got a choice here. It depends on where you want to define that boundary and how severe you think this is. But you need to think about this and say, what am I willing to tolerate? Am I willing to accept this at all? And if not, then what am I going to do about the situation? So if you do stick in the situation, you do decide that this is worth it, that you are learning from this environment, and that you're going to stay with this job, then obviously, you know, if you feel like this is a violation of your boundaries, you need to make that clear. You need to say, you know, a lot of people avoid conflict because they think conflict is bad. Conflict isn't bad. Not knowing how to deal with conflict correctly is bad. You got to be tough. I'll be honest with you. You got to be. You can't be hurt very easily. You got to be tough, but you got to confront and you got to be gentle at the same time, right? So that's the way, you know. If you think about like a warrior, a calm warrior who can calmly. They don't hate their enemy. They're just doing their job as they slash through their. You know, and do their thing, right? That's you in conflict, okay? You be that. So you got to confront this person, and you got to say, look, I appreciate, you know, start with the, you know, this is the shit sandwich, right? Good, bad, good, okay? So start with the good. Say, look, here's the thing. I really like admire you. You're a really good developer. Like, pick some good things about them. Honestly, don't make up stuff. Like, pick honest stuff. There's always something you can admire about someone, even if it's just that they have nice blue eyes, whatever it is. You know, pick something about them, honestly, though, with their work, seriously. And then tell them, say, look, I appreciate you, and I appreciate you that you're trying to help me, but I do not consider what you're doing constructive, and I really don't appreciate it. It is not acceptable. If you want to help me, if you think that my code is not good, if you think it's not right, tell me, but give me real reasons. Don't say, Don't say, oh, this sucks. Don't say, what the hell? That's unacceptable. I will not tolerate that. And I don't have to do that. And I don't appreciate it. And just be firm with that, you know, and tell them clearly that you will not, that there is no way that you're going to tolerate this. And then follow it up and say, you know, that's the other end of the sandwich and some nice stuff, you know. By the way, you know, this was great. You know, I liked how you did this and stuff and, you know, and make it nice, right? So they'll eat it. but they don't have to eat it. That's the thing, is right? If they don't, that's fine. Then you're either out of there or go and take it to management and say, look, this is the thing. You know, I've tried to work this out, but this is a problem. I consider this abuse. I'm not going to accept this. You know, I will leave. I would, you know, if you don't deal with this problem, you know, that's not tattletaling on someone. That's drawing a line and you know, and dealing with the problem. If you do decide to leave, then, you know, then don't say anything. That's the thing. Like if you do leave, I would say, don't say why you're leaving. Right? Don't because the only bad can come from that. You could get, you know, get someone spreading rumors about you. There's no point. If you just decide that you're done, then you're done. You're either firm and you say, I will not tolerate this. This is the line, or you get out of there. You don't go somewhere in the middle where people can walk over you or where you're using an ultimatum to threaten them. If you do this, I will do that. None of that. You're either making the decision. You're either quitting or you're staying. If you're staying, you're drawing the line. So anyway, I hope that helps you. And just so you know, that is not normal. It's not regular. Someone should not be treating you like that in a professional manner. I mean, we've had worse. We've all probably, or some of us have had worse. You know, I've had people yelling in my face and I've not tolerated it. You know, sometimes I have tolerated it and regretted it. But I'm telling you now that you got to draw that line. And if you don't, it's going to get worse. So anyway, hopefully that helps you. If you've got a question for me, email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And if you like this video, subscribe. Take care.